There was an anti-encroachment drive at a legendary Shivaji fort in Kolhapur that turned violent. This anti-encroachment drive was at the Vishalgarh fort, but it took an ugly turn. Miscreants started to resort to violence, roughing up even local shopkeepers and pelted stones at the cops on duty at the fort premises. Former Rajya Sabha Member of Parliament Chhatrapati Sambhaji Raje Bhosle, along with hundreds of supporters, staged a march to the fort where he had given a public call to end encroachments around that area. But before he could even reach the fort, a group of miscreants reportedly, as you can see visuals on the ground, started to vandalize shops, start to pelt stones and even attacked policemen on duty. Miscreants, we are told, are antisocial elements, targeted religious structures and thrashed residents too. There's been CCTV that has captured some visuals where the cops are clearly being attacked by these miscreants. Vehicles vandalized, houses were set ablaze. So there was clearly an alarming situation there in Kolhapur, while eventually the cops had to resort to lathi charge to disperse the protesters.
जिस तरह का अतिक्रमण विशालगढ़ में हुआ था वो किसी शिवभक्त को अच्छा नहीं लगता था, वो आक्रोश था उनमें, इसलिए ये उठाव था। इतना विकृत पद्धत से वो अतिक्रमण हुआ था और सरकार ने आज निर्णय लिया है शिवभक्त के आक्रोश देख के कि कल से ये सब अतिक्रमण मुक्त होने की प्रोसेस प्रक्रिया ये शुरू होगी।
सिचुएशन बिल्कुल अंडर कंट्रोल है। सुबह से जो दो एजिटेशन विशालगढ़ का जो एनक्रोचमेंट है उसके बारे में हो रहे थे, जो मॉब वहाँ पे जमा हुआ था दो लीडर के अंडर, वो वापस जाते वक्त कुछ वैंडलिज्म उन्होंने किया है। बेसिकली नाउ एडिशनल फोर्स हमें मिल चुकी है, वो डिप्लॉय हो चुकी है। अभी कोई भी आंदोलन या दंगाई यहाँ पे उपस्थित नहीं है। इसकी आगे की जो प्रक्रिया है, इसके जो जिन्होंने ये सब वैंडलिज्म किया है उनको आइडेंटिफाई किया जा रहा है। एफआईआर रजिस्ट्रेशन प्रोग्रेस में है।
आई एम नाउ जॉइंड इन दिस टेलीकास्ट बाय माय कॉलीग मुस्तफा शेख। मुस्तफा, गुड मॉर्निंग। व्हाट एग्जैक्टली हैपेंड इन कोल्हापुर एंड व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन लाइक राइट नाउ?
Well, Pooja, you can say that this is, a case of political leaders or leaders trying to take control of law and order situation. You can say that Sambhaji Raje Chhatrapati was upset with the illegal construction which has taken place on Vishalgarh in Kolhapur. So he had decided to take out a march with his supporters at Vishalgarh, and the plan was apparently to remove the illegal construction. Before that, before his march could reach, some miscreants stone pelted, and there were even policemen were injured in this entire incident. Houses were burnt, vehicles were burnt, and then today the government has decided to remove the illegal structures. The questions which are being raised is that a legal process could have been followed if there were illegal construction and there was a way to do it. But yes, you can say it was a rioting-like situation which happened in Kolhapur, after which the police had to register a case. And now, given the pressure from the people and from his supporters, the government is saying that they will remove the illegal structures. Now, interestingly, if it would have been any other case, the opposition of Maharashtra would have said that the law and order situation in Maharashtra is not good, the government is not able to take care of it. But because Sambhaji Raja Chhatrapati is the son of Shahu Maharaj Chhatrapati, who has recently become the member of parliament from Congress in Kolhapur, the opposition also is not raising any voice or pointing out any law and order issue in this entire episode. But today, around 160 illegal structures at Vishalgarh will be brought down, is what information we are getting from the sources in the government. Back to you, Pooja.
Right, Mustafa, keep tracking the latest coming in, because these are disturbing scenes that we can see, and perhaps it's important that the cops immediately take the situation in control. Mustafa, thank you very much for now.